Hi, this is Belkasoft Evidence Center tutorial series. Today we will show how you can filter data in various data lists in Evidence Center to narrow your search. In my case, I already have some data extracted. Let me go to the Overview tab and select Browser Links. In particular, I am interested in all Google searches. To see them, I need to create a filter. I click Add Filter button. Select Search Engine Criterion. And check Google Insight. After the filter is created, you can see that just 24 links were shown out of 300, and all of them are indeed for Google. Let me hide some unnecessary columns, and one of the columns rest is search term, which helps you to figure out what a user was searching. Let me apply another useful filter. Before that, I need to remove the existing filter, what can be done using the cross button. You can see that the list is reset and all items are shown. Then I create a new filter and now select category criterion. Here you can see all categories available for your particular case. Evidence Center can classify adult sites, cloud applications, dating sites, peer-to-peer links, and social networks. It will not show you categories which did not appear in your case, so for my case it shows social networks only. Let me apply the filter and see the results. Now, you can see which visited browser links are social network links. Filters are especially useful when working with pictures because pictures can have so many properties. Let me first filter only those pictures which have GPS coordinates. I select pictures with GPS criterion. Six pictures are filtered, all having GPS coordinates. I can select one or multiple pictures and show them on Google Maps or Google Earth. You can perfectly see famous tower bridge in London. Another useful filter here is camera manufacturer and camera name. For example, I can choose photos made with Apple or Canon. Or if I go to camera name, I can specify exact camera, for example iPhone 4. Note that only those models which present in the particular case are shown, not every existing camera. By the way, the item count column shows you how many results you are going to get in the filtered list, and there are no zeros. Of course, you can combine several criteria, and the final number of items in a list may be smaller, but not greater. What other filters exist for pictures? You can filter pictures and all other types of artifacts by data source. Data source is any carrier containing data, such as a hard drive, a mobile device, a virtual machine, and so on. If you have multiple devices in a case, it might be handy to separate data from one particular device of interest. There is also a filter by file type, such as JPEG or PNG. You can filter all file-based artifacts like pictures or documents by path or a substring in path. There is also a filter by file size. You can specify bytes, kilobytes, megabytes, or gigabytes here. I believe in a few years we will have to add terabytes and petabytes, but not for now. You can filter pictures by various file times and actually all other file-based artifacts. You can filter them by different types of time, such as file access time, file creation time, and file modification time. You can see interesting filter called file origin. Pictures may be originated from different sources. They can be files from a drive, pictures attached to chats, pictures embedded to documents such as Word or PowerPoint, pictures from email attachments, pictures from thumbnail files, and so on. You can easily review all email attachments. Let us filter pictures from email attachments, remove the filter by camera name, and make sure we can see 6 pictures from emails. Let me next run picture analysis. Let me run face detection. Face detection robustly detects profile and frontal faces inside your picture set, so you can easily find various persons. Apart from face detection, the product also supports skin detection, which is called pornography analysis, text detection with instant OCR, and forgery detection, which detects any traces of editing a photo in a photo editor. When analysis is completed, the first question is, where is my result? To get the result, we again go to filters. Now I'm going to analysis results. And I'm going to specify pictures with faces. Okay, now I have some results. And every face has a green box around it. Now, let me go to chats and filter conversations. Here I have a lot of various chats, but I'm going to filter only Skype chats. Actually, this can be partially done in Case Explorer, where you can see all sky profiles. For example, you can see two profiles in my particular case. However, when you need to see all Skype chats in the same list, overview is more convenient. To see only Skype chats in overview, I'm creating a filter and going to profile criterion. Here I have so much profiles that it's really hard to find necessary ones. For such situations, there is a text field called find. It works like a filter inside filters. I type Skype, and Evidence Center looks for Skype in any column available here, including profile, type, and path. That's pretty handy. Let me select only Skype version 4. Seventy-four chats are filtered out. Notice two icons of Skype in the filter panel. When you move your mouse over one of them, a hint shows you the profile details, so you can remember which profiles from which data source you have chosen. Let me add another filter. And now I'm going to filter by sender. First, I would like to filter a guy called Sebastian from letter C. Okay. Some results are shown and selected by default. Now I would like to add another guy, but how do I do that without losing my results for Sebastian? And for this, here is a checkbox Add checked items to filter. I select it before typing another sender name. And another name is Professor via C letter. Good. Now I have both senders and I have chats filtered to see conversations originating from these two guys. Let me also fill another criterion, text. As I am looking for some secret conversations, I enter secret here. There is just one single chat filtered out, so I'd like to change my mind and disable filter by text. How do I do that without deleting it? For this, there is a checkbox at the filter panel which temporarily switches selected filter off, what is handy when you are playing with multiple filters. Now I'm switching to Case Explorer and select Timeline. Timeline contains thousands or even millions of events, so it definitely needs filtering. I am interested in all boot times of a computer. I add a filter and go to event type. There are multiple event types, but I'm interested only in booting computer, so I type boot in the find text box. Okay, now I have all boot times for the computer. I can select some or all of them and create a report. Belkasoft Evidence Center makes your investigation easier, faster, more comprehensive and more effective. You can download the full trial version at belkasoft.com/trial.